we reached 2,140% more, not just more accounts, but percent more accounts in the last 30 days. We had almost 10,000 content interactions, 1,412 new followers. We only had to share 14 posts. If you want to get more Instagram followers, you're going to have to do things that other creators don't. You're going to need to stay on top of trends and innovate them. You're going to need to be constantly providing value, posting content consistently, and figuring out a way to stand out in an oversaturated market. And that's what this video is all about. For each one of these tips, we're going to be doing a deep dive into the different kinds of Instagram content. Stories, Reels, IGTVs, you're going to get it all. Let's get into it. Growing your following is obviously important, but monetizing that following is even more important. And later on, I'm going to talk about a little $7 kit that I created to help you make money on Instagram. For now though, let's talk about growing your audience. All right, so here we are on my Instagram account, and I want to point out the ways that we do our regular Instagram content. And we're going to break this down into the three kinds of posts that have been doing really well for us: photos of me, carousel posts, and quote posts. Let's do carousels and quotes first, because those have been working really well for us. So basically what we do when we create our quotes is we think of something that not only that I resonate with, but that our audience will resonate with. So when we make our quotes, we really think about what is something that our audience will think about, will comment on, will save, and will share. So as you're creating these quotes, it's really important to think about coming at it from the perspective of what your ideal clients, which your audience members want to read, share, and save. What we'll do is we'll post the quote on Twitter, take a screenshot of it, and then add it a colored background to it, and then we'll post it. It's really that simple. Where we can, we'll actually expand upon the quote post by doing a swipe with other photos, other screenshots, other videos, anything to add a little bit more depth and make it more visually interesting for our readers who come across this quote. With the quote post, here's the secret sauce thing that everybody needs to do. Everybody needs to take away and do this. But what we will do is, once in the caption of our quote post, we'll actually tell them to take the next step. We'll tell them, you know, comment below, share this to your Instagram story. We're very clear with our next step for our readers. And because we tell them what to do, they typically do that. So we see a lot more engagement simply because we asked for it. So in this one, we said, DM me with the word uplevel, and we started a sales conversation with them. So people are doing what we tell them to do, and we're getting more engagement simply by asking for it. Carousels. Now, carousels are meaty informational posts that are specifically created to get more saves or shares. I like to think of them like mini blog posts. We can look at a couple examples here. Here's a carousel post that I made that talked about how I hit 20,000 Instagram followers. And so you can swipe through and you can see really what this is it's notes that I typed out in the notes section of my computer, took screenshots of, and posted to Instagram. But they're extremely, extremely valuable. And if we look at my insights here, you can see they perform really well, especially when you look at the amount of saves they get. So this one has 182 saves. This one here, it has 248 saves. So these carousel swipe posts perform extremely well. And I know they've been really instrumental in us getting a lot of followers recently. So the key here with the carousels, as you make them, the little secret sauce tip is don't overdo them. The more simple, the better they are. So for me, I will literally just create them in the notes on my computer, screenshot them, and add them to Instagram. And people like that because they like to feel like they're getting a little sneak peek into the notes on your phone. There's nothing like a good old-fashioned regular photo of yourself, but I want to talk about how you can spice it up. The one thing that we always do really, really well with regular photos of me is we do one thing to spice it up, one thing to make it look different, one thing to make it stand out. So here's a great example of it. We scroll down a bit here. This is a photo of me, but it's also a little GIF of me kind of coming up there. It's very visually eye-catching when you click on it. If we go to this one here and we start swiping through it, you can see that we actually did this really addictive thing where when you swipe, it actually gives the full horizontal photo. People love this and they'll look at your photo longer, which tells the Instagram algorithm, this is a good photo. People are looking at it, show it to more people. The last thing that I like to do a lot is I like to throw in a swipe photo with something somewhat related, but not exactly related. And why I do this is because people could be scrolling through their feed, they could see the second photo and be like, what's this about? And then they'll read the caption, which actually leads me to one of the most important things about sharing a regular photo of yourself. Use it as an opportunity to teach and to provide value. So if we look at the captions on all of my posts here, I share a helpful topic. So for example, This one, I'm talking about how I showed up and hit 20,000 Instagram followers. This one, I'm talking about why did you start your business? Each one of the photos that I share of myself isn't just, hey, it's a picture of Maria. It's an opportunity to connect with your audience, to provide value, and to teach them something that they didn't know. IGTVs. If you're not currently posting IGTVs, I think you're missing out. IGTVs are a really good way to share value and warm up your audience, get them to know you better, build trust, and again, provide value. So if we go into my most recent IGTV and we kind of look at the analytics here, you can see some of the insights on how well IGTVs have been working for us. This was a time-sensitive topic video that we created, and it had almost 5,000 views, it had almost 500 likes, it had almost 200 comments, and almost 200 shares. That means that almost 200 people saw this IGTV and shared it with their people. Not only that, it had almost 70 saves. And so this is something that we really have realized is that IGTVs are great conversation starters, and they're a really great way for you to build your expertise, for you to help people trust you as an expert. Now, my pro tip with the IGTVs is to keep it simple and to keep the topics on something relevant to your industry, something that's currently trending. We've done a lot of different IGTVs and we've noticed that if you make your Instagram story, you know, your IGTV topic on something that's relevant to what's going on in your industry, you're going to get more views, more comments, and more shares. Now, when most people create IGTVs, at best, they're usually just talking at their phones and maybe they'll throw some subtitles on it so people can watch it if they don't have audio, which isn't bad. Don't get me wrong, that's not bad. But I wanna talk about how you can elevate your IGTVs to really help it stand out from the crowd. So we decided to put a little bit more effort into our IGTVs, and what we did is we edited them. We added B-roll shots. B-roll shots are background shots. We added nice captions. We added little text things. We basically did music. We did what we needed to do to really help our IGTVs be separated from everybody else's. And that's one of the reasons we believe they're doing so well. They're high quality and they look different than all the other IGTVs out there. If you wanna do this yourself, we use a music website called Epidemic Sounds. If you wanted to do your own footage, your own background shots, you can simply take background shots with your iPhone and just record yourself doing things as B-roll shots. B-roll is just background shots. So for me, it might be me working at my desk, it might be me getting a cup of coffee. Keep it simple, don't overcomplicate it. If you don't have B-roll footage of yourself, you can also just go to regular stock footage sites and do that. So we used B-roll shots here of a stock footage of the Huntington Beach Pier. So you can see here, the Huntington Beach Pier, just some regular stock footage. It's a great example of what B-roll can look like. It doesn't have to be complicated, it can be really simple, and it's a great way to just visually spice things up. Reels. Everybody and their mother is creating Instagram Reels, and for good reason. Instagram Reels are one of the biggest things giving you more followers. For instance, take a look at this reel here that we put out earlier last week. It already has 147,000 views and it's still growing. When we refresh, you know, 20 minutes from now, it'll probably be at 150,000 views. And that's just one of them. That's the one that's doing the best. You can see here, another one we put out a couple days ago has 222,000 views. Another one we put out just an hour ago is already almost at 2,000. Not only are they getting a lot of views and a lot of engagement, they're also giving us a ton of followers. So this is your sign to officially start creating Instagram Reels. The last type of content that we've really been liking and doing well with on Instagram is stories. And I wanna share one of the tips from my video, 6 ways to get more views on your Instagram stories. You can actually check that out here. Now, the one tip that I wanna share with you today is if you are noticing that your stories aren't getting a lot of views, if there's not a lot of engagement going on, you wanna do what's called a story reset. So take a full 24-hour break from your Instagram stories. And then when you post a new story, post it with a poll. So what that does is it creates a bunch of engagement on your first post after 24 hours, and it tells Instagram, oh, people like her stories, let's show them to more people. So if you're finding that you're having trouble getting engagement or views on your Instagram stories, take a 24-hour break, and then after that 24-hour period, make a story with a poll. If you're curious to know how these strategies, how these content hacks have been working for us, I thought you might like a little sneak peek into our Instagram insights. So let's go ahead and take a look together. So you can see here when we switched to the last 30 days, which is when we really started getting serious about our Instagram account, we reached 2,140% more, not just more accounts, but percent more accounts in the last 30 days. We reached 149,000 accounts. We had almost 10,000 content interactions. We increased our audience by 1,412 new followers. We only had to share 14 posts, which isn't that much. It's a post every other day. And a lot of these are really easy to do. The quote posts take 20 minutes, if that. They're very simple posts to do. And then we only did 2 IGTV videos. So we're not even doing that many posts. We're not doing that much content, but the results that we're seeing has been phenomenal. We've grown by just exponentially because of these little content hacks we're using. It's fun stuff to look at. As we said earlier, when it comes to Instagram, growing followers is important, but knowing how to monetize those followers is even more important, which is why I created the Ultimate Make Money on Instagram Kit, where I walk you through exactly what I did to make $100,000 months using Instagram. This kit is just $7, and if you're ready to start getting serious about making money on Instagram, it's perfect for you. I'm linking to it in the description below. Make sure you grab a copy of it. Thank you so much. If you like this video, if you found it helpful, click the like button. And if you want to make sure you don't miss any of these social media strategy videos that I do, click the subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next video.